Okay, so welcome to the last video for today, which is the last video of the tutorials. I will go through one more tutorial, which is going to include now an input as well as an output. I'm also going to talk about the rest of the tutorials, just a trick or what you need to do. And then finally, I'm going to close with this video. Then you need to continue with the rest of the tutorials as well as the exercise in order to learn part one of Arduino. In this part one, by the way, we only have LEDs, buttons, and that's all. We don't have even sensors yet, because that will be the next class next week. Okay, so right now we have this task. First of all, a little bit of clarification. Hold means you have to press on the button and keep pressing it down. It's not a click. It's not this. You'll have to hold it down. So you have to press the button and hold it. Only then the LED will switch on. The difference between this and here is, this is called press. I think this should be click, but anyway, this meant is, this next tutorial, I'm not gonna do it, you will do it. The idea is that here you don't actually hold the button and just click on it. You click the button, the status of the LED will change. Basically, if it was switched on, it will off. You click again, it will on. You click again, it will off. So it will toggle. Toggle means keep on changing. And it's not going to be able to hold. It's basically going to click. You click, it will change. One more tutorial is basically one button, but two LEDs. You press one button, they both switch on. This is actually easier than the previous one, but it's already there. And there's one more thing, which is the exercise, which is essentially there's no circuit. You'll have to build the circuit yourself. You have to figure it out. And then also you have to build the system. So I'll leave this one for you as an exercise. So this will be the lab sheet for this week. Okay, so I'll get back to our tutorial, which is right here. No, this one, right here. So let's go to Tinkercad and build it. So once again, I'm gonna try to create the same look. Okay, so there's only one LED, so let's just throw away some stuff. So I don't need this, I need this. Okay, so what else do we need? So I'm just gonna put this guy up here. Okay, so we are now here, and then what's next is, what is this light? Oh, okay. So I need a button and another, and I need a button as well as a resistor. Okay, let's go get a button. So, oh, here's the button right there, push button. And by the way, in the slides, you might notice that called push button two separate words. Actually, that's a mistake. It's push button one word. So just to be consistent with Tinkercad. Okay, let's get back here now. So we need one more resistor. So thank you. So we can take this resistor right here. Is it to the ground? Yes. And then we are, yep, these are connected. And oh wait, yes, this also works, and this also works, it's fine. Okay, so now what we need to do right now is to connect to the ground. So right here, that's good enough. Yeah, from here to one of these, it doesn't matter. I can put this one here, here, anywhere, it doesn't matter, they are all connected. Okay, and then from here also goes to the same ground. Okay, so right here goes to here. Now, by the way, you don't have to do the exact same drawing because this was done for a different purpose, but for doesn't matter from here. As long as you come from this line and you end up on one of these, it's okay. So that's the same effect. And then from these two, we need a ground to go to the ground here. Okay, so I'm gonna go from, okay, fine, let's just do this. Okay, so now it's the same thing, and now I can actually come now and do this. Click, click, all the way to this ground here, and then click, and click. So now we have grounded the resistor, the LED, as well as the button. Okay, what's next? Now we need to have the output. This is 13 again. Okay, so 13, click, oops, click, and click, and right here. Don't worry about it. I think it's fine, but yeah. Okay, connected. What's next? Just a little bit of clarity, different color. So let's put this as blue. Yeah, okay. And then we need this guy, which is the output, which is from here. I forgot which pin. Oh, 7. Okay. Okay. How do you get rid of these extra stops? Oh, okay. So just click on those extra dots and then delete button. It will be gone. And then, oh, there's one more. Okay, delete that too. And then just move this last one until we get the same result. And this one, I'm gonna change the color to something nice. Not red, turquoise, no. Purple, yeah, okay. So this is it. So we've done already our drawing and the circuit hardware is done. So you have resistor goes to the ground. Oh wait, there's one more thing. Actually, there is, yes, there's one more thing, which is the power source. So we need 5 volt. I don't know why we need 5 volt here, because this 5 volt here comes here. It's not, oh, it's the resistor. Yes, to the resistor. So we need, see, after you press, the reason why there's, the way the button works is that it's actually connected to the circuit. And the circuit is essentially the power. So once you press on the power, it will actually provide the power to the board, which is then gonna feed it from here to the input. See, power comes here. Then once you click the button, it's gonna be fed as an input into the board itself. So we need 5 volt. Is it 5 volt? Yeah, 5 volt. Yeah, and I'm gonna put a blank here. So now the power comes here. Any one of these will be connected to it. So we're gonna take it through the resistor, goes to the button, and then the button provides the power to as an input. Input, remember, input takes the information to the from the item to the board, then gives the instructions, and then takes the command to the LED to switch it on and off. Take a look at the code. Well, this is the code from before, so it won't work for us, so we'll have to throw it away. So I'm gonna, yeah. Yeah, I have 3 items, which is this, and I have 2 items for setup, and we have the program. And we're just gonna throw away this guy right here. Well, actually, no. I need digital write. Yes, digital write and sleep. I need those as well. We don't need for this. Okay, so now let's take a look at the program. Now we don't have red and blue anymore. We have LED and we have buttons. So LED, LED, and button. And sleep is sleep. And then the LED actually is 13. And the button is 7. Let's quick check. LED 13, yes. And the button goes to 7. Okay, done. So if you don't like to write this much name, so you can call it LED also here, can, like this. Now this is too easy. So, but and LED, capital letters, LED. Or if you want, you can just keep it red as well, because it's red color. So we don't have to change the code down there. Okay, so now LED is an output. I agree, because this is the light. But what about the button? Well, this is actually is an input. So button, okay, enough of that. So button. So we're gonna call this now input, because the button is an input. it sends information to the board rather than receiving information to the board. So now we have set the button as an input. Okay, so before we actually write code, we need to write algorithm. Remember that part? So what's the algorithm here? If button is pressed, press and hold, switch on LED. Else, switch off LED. All right, so all we have to do now is to basically transform this into a program. So let's see how, obviously this is actually calls for an if statement. So if something, right? How's the if statement? This is Python. So where is, it's very similar to the while, right? Yeah, so bracket, okay. So let's get back to here. So if something, and then we have a bracket right here, then we have to close the bracket. It's all right. Else, and then we have the bracket and close it. All right. So essentially, then we have to actually put here this condition. What's going on here is that we need to know the status of the button. How do you know whether the button is pressed or not? When you actually physically press on the button, when you run the program and you press on the button, the status of the button will change. The button has two statuses. Can you actually pluralize? Does the status have plural? Anyway, there's two conditions of the button. It's either pressed or not pressed. Is that right? Now, in programming language, the way we do that actually is slightly different. So I'm going to come here now and say, pressed in real life means low, and not pressed or released equal high. Is it? Actually, I forgot. I'm gonna cheat a little bit, so I'm gonna. Yeah, I'm right. So essentially, if it's pressed, that means low. And if it's not pressed, then it is high. Okay, so how are we gonna check whether it's pressed or not? Well, remember this, which is digital write. Digital write means go and do this. Go and set it equal to high or set it equal to low, is that right? Well, if you figured it out already, if you want to check the status of it, you have to do is digital read. Basically now, what we're going to do is we're going to check the status of the button. Button, and essentially here. If digital status of the button is equal to low, I think so, that's the code, right? Yeah, if it's equal to low, if this is the status, button essentially is because we set it up here, button and button. If the status is equal to low, then what are you gonna do then? Switch on the LED. How do you switch it on? Well, it's right here. And we're gonna put a little bit of sleep as well. Well, actually, we don't have to, I'll test it. All right. Else. Now we can actually put else like this, which is general, but we could also do else if. So just to be exactly 100% in control of our if statement. So it's going to put else if just like that. And then if this was low or high, then we're going to switch it off. Low. So that's, and then this one is extra now, so we don't need it. So what's going on here? Basically, we actually achieved this. First of all, if the button has been pressed, press and hold right, switch on LED. It's all right? Okay. This is how we check the status of the button. We're going to digital read rather than digital write. Digital read the status of the button. If the status of the button is equal to low, in other words, it's pressed. This is low means pressed. This is usually for the button. Button status. So low, press means low, and not pressed or released means high. So if it's pressed low, then switch on the LED, digital write, just like we did in the previous tutorial. And then we are consistently, now we want to check, we don't want to use else, we just want to check the other condition, that if it's released, which is like this, then switch off the LED. Okay, and for now, I'm not going to put any kind of wait or sleep. I'm going to keep it that way. So let's hope it works. So start running and initializing. Well, you see nothing is happening because yes, this is not a blinking program. What happens is that if I press here, this should be switched on. How do you press on a button here? We just bring the mouse here and click and hold the mouse. Yay, it works. Release the mouse, it's off again. Press, release, it works. In other words, our program worked like a charm. And basically, that's how the press button works. So once again, I'm gonna go through it. Basically, this is how you check the status of the button. Essentially, notice how, by the way, that the program now is easier to read now. Button, maybe red here is not nice. Maybe you should have called it LED. But anyway, yeah, I think so. LED and copy, and I'm gonna LED, and here is also LED and LED. Yeah. So yeah, there's no need for sleep because this is not a blinking program. So I'm gonna throw away this whole thing just to make the program a little bit clearer, and I'm gonna also throw away this one right here. Of course, some people would say, or some of you might be saying, you don't have to use else if, else will be nice, can, but I just want to be sure about the code. And this is it. So now this is the setup, and this is the program. So once again, run it, and it's come here with the mouse, click, hold, and it's blinking, click again, and it's done. And that's it. This is now the third tutorial. And which is essentially hold the push button to switch on the LED. And the program is right here as well. Maybe the program is slightly different than, oh, this is the toggle program, no. Yeah, this is the program that we did. They use else, I just use else if. It's up to you, whichever like you like. Now, the second tutorial, or the next tutorial, I'm not gonna do it, but you're gonna do it yourself. Now, what we want here is to toggle. This is essentially click, should be click actually, not push. And the idea is if I just click on it like this, this will switch on the status. If it was already off, click once, it will be on. Click again, it will be off. Click again, it will be off. So every time you click on it, the status of the LED changes. So I suggest strongly that you try and figure it out yourself. The code is right here, but I just don't want you to go through it. I want you to do it yourself. So use it as a challenge. Build the circuit, yes, and then try to figure it out yourself. You can definitely Google it and so on and so forth. The following tutorial after that is actually very, very easy. This should have been 4 and this should have been 5, but it's okay. This one essentially is one button, two LEDs. Essentially, you'll have to extend the program that we already wrote. Just add one more LED, and then when you press this button, the two LEDs will switch on. This is very easy to use. You just have to add the hardware and then modify the code a little bit, and then it will work just fine. Essentially, just like you have, other than just one LED, you'll have one more LED here and one more LED here. You'll have to set up one more here and set up one more here. And of course, you'll have to actually add the other LED here as well. So I'll leave that part for you easy. The other one, which is about the toggle, is a little bit of tricky because that's why I want to leave it for you to check it out yourself. Then after that, I want you to do as well is the exercise. The difference between exercise and the tutorials is that the exercise does not give you the circuit yourself. Instead, part of the workout is that you have to figure out the circuit yourself. But everything you see here is all LEDs and buttons, very similar to what we have done before. So if you finish all the tutorials, all the 5 or 6 tutorials up, then you'll be familiar to work with LEDs and sensors. Every time you need to add an LED, then you obviously need to add a resistor and then ground on one side and select an input on the other side. Same thing for the button. Every time you use a button, you have to use a resistor on one side, power source on one side, and then on output on one side. And the rest is just the same. So you have to figure out how many buttons you need and how many LEDs you need. And then, of course, the functionality, which is right here. Okay? So I'll leave that part for you. So for this tutorial or for this lab sheet, lab sheet 3, which is Arduino, this program right here is your lab sheet. You are required to develop the lab sheet that is going to achieve this. So how are you going to submit this? Well, first of all, you're going to have to go and build the circuit here in Tinkercad. Write the code you see here. Write the code that is actually suitable to run the program and then run the simulation. You don't have to... what you're going to do, you're going to take this file right here, copy it, and then save it in a C++ program or text, it's fine. Even if you go to Notepad and then create a file and then put the file here and then save it and then file, save. Okay, this is it. So I need you to write the program, and then once you write the program, save it. And then as usual, basically you're going to use the same file convention, ls3-your ID number. So what you're going to do is that you're going to actually essentially, you're going to submit the program to me, and you're going to also give me the screenshot of your program, of your circuit. Then what I'm going to do, I'm going to take your program, and then I'm going to put it in my own Tinkercad and then run it. And if it runs properly, then we will be considered job done. I'm going to build the circuit myself on my side, and then I'm going to wait for you to write for your program. So once again, here's how it's going to work. On my side, I'm going to build the circuit, but I'm not going to write any program. It will be blank. Okay? What are you going to do then in this case? You're going to do the same thing on your side in Tinkercad and develop the program and then run it. Once it's run successfully, then you're going to have to save the file and then send it to me and then submit it on Moodle as usual. I'm going to create one more lab sheet for you. Once you put it there, then I'm going to actually take it from there, put it into my own Tinkercad, and then run the program. And if it runs successfully, then we're good to go. You can also, if you want, put screenshots. If you're able to record the screen, if you know how to record the screen, then it's even easier because you can actually then record yourself doing the tutorial like what I'm doing right now. Just very few seconds of you running your tutorial, your program, that'll be also nice. So I'll leave the way for you to do it. So, all right. So thank you very much and all the best in your tutorial, and I'll see you in our next class next week.